Why do so many of us dream the same dreams? Falling through endless space, running but never moving, showing up to class unprepared, or worse, without clothes. Across culture, age, and language, these archetypes repeat themselves, as if the human brain shares a universal mythology written in code. Carl Jung called these shared patterns archetypes, universal symbols from the collective unconscious. They are the mind's shorthand, a symbolic vocabulary that helps us express what logic can't articulate. Take falling for example. It rarely means physical danger. Instead, it mirrors a loss of control, a relationship slipping, a fear of failure, or the instability of uncertain future. Flying, on the other hand, often signals liberation, creativity, or a hunger for escape. The moment your feet leave the ground in a dream, your psyche might be testing the limits of freedom you deny yourself when awake. Then there is nudity, not about the exposure of the body, but the exposure of truth, its vulnerability, its fear of being seen, or perhaps the desire to be finally seen for who you are. Even water, one of the most recurring dream symbols, carries layers of meaning. Calm seas often reflect peace and emotional clarity, while turbulent waves may signal inner turmoil. Houses often represent the self, each room a different part of your consciousness. A dark basement might symbolize buried memories, a locked door, an unacknowledged emotion. And while these symbols feel universal, their meaning is deeply personal. A snake might mean fear to one person, transformation to another. A storm might represent danger or the thrill of renewal. Dreams speak a language of emotion, not translation. So instead of asking, what does this symbol mean? The better question might be, what does it mean right now? Your dreams are not fortune cookies. They are mirrors. And in their reflection lies the story of who you are, what you fear, and what you are still becoming.